बराए रास्त आपको दिखाएंगे। शिबली फराज इस वक्त तकरीब से खिताब कर रहे हैं।
amid grave human rights violations, mass detentions and extrajudicial killings. The condition of Muslims in the rest of India is no different. They face extreme discrimination, mob attacks, lack of police protection and now even the fear of loss of citizenship. The Discriminatory Citizen Amendment Act announced in December 2019 grants amnesty to religious minorities including Hindus, Sikhs, Jain, Buddhist, Parsis and Christians who migrated to India prior to 2015 from Muslim majority countries like Pakistan, Afghanistan or Bangladesh. Unsurprisingly, the only major religion that has been left out is Islam, the second largest religion in India with over 200 million followers. Additionally, the implementation of a National Register of Citizenship, NRC, nationwide forces millions of Muslims to prove their citizenship or fear being taken to internment camps. In order to qualify for inclusion in the official NRC in Assam, all Muslim residents had to provide the government with evidence that their families had migrated to India before 1971. Hence, to ensure their right to remain in the country of their birth, generations of Indian Muslims now need to provide their grandparents legal documents, most of which did not exist anymore. This transition of Indian politics towards Islamophobia has been gradual and well thought out. Let me reconstruct key developments that have cemented and strengthened this hate rhetoric led by Modi over the past many years. The first major blow to religious diversity and inclusion in India came in 1992 when Babri Mosque in Ayodhya was stormed by tens of thousands of Hindus. The ghostly face of Modi politics was fully exposed in 2002 during Gujarat riots, which earned him the famous title, the Butcher of Gujarat. The violence that Modi instigated as Chief Minister Gujarat has now spread all across India like wildfire, and this time, as the Premier, he has the leverage to play with national legislations and international politics as well. Unfortunately, Modi's doctrine is nothing but a campaign of racial and religious hatred. It is only a matter of time before this Modi-fueled fascism turns fatal and tears down the social fabric of India. Today, the slogan of Shining India is scarred with incidents of mob lynching of Dalit untouchables, caste, beating up of Muslims on account of cow meat, failure of police to protect minorities, and deprivation of Muslims of their birth citizenship. Mr. Modi needs to be snubbed as his Islamophobic designs don't augur well for global peace. Modi needs to understand that minorities in India deserve the right to equality before the law, freedom of religion, and protection from religious hate. In the end, I would like to highlight that Prime Minister Imran Khan raised the issue of Islamophobia at the highest forums of United Nations. I would also like to reiterate that we will continue to highlight this discrimination against Muslims at all forums. Thank you very much.
सेनेटर शिबली फराज सेमिनार से खिताब कर रहे हैं। इस पर उनका ये कहना है कि भारत की जानिब से जिस किस्म की इंसानी हकूक की खिलाफ वर्जी की जा रही है। मकबूजा कश्मीर में एक साल से ज़ायद का अरसा गुजर चुका है, वहाँ पर लॉकडाउन की सूरत हाल है। मोदी हुकूमत भारत में मुसलमानों को समाजी सियासी नुकसान पहुँचा रही है। भारत ने मकबूजा कश्मीर में एक साल से गैर कानूनी लॉकडाउन किया हुआ है।